Hello, and welcome to BECAfest 2021. I'm your host, Clarissa.
And I'm your other host, Lupe.
We are so excited to be here with you on this beautiful afternoon in front of the new LCA building, where students in the BECA department will be enjoying the best media facilities in the country.
And though we have been facing very challenging times, such as a global pandemic, an attempted coup at the Capitol, and the ongoing violence towards our Black and Asian American brothers and sisters, I'm very excited for moments like this, you know, where we can experience unity.
That's right, Lupe. Unity. And no matter what, we'll always have new experiences to share, like Zooming while muted.
And never actually wearing pants.
Wait, you never actually wore any pants? Before we begin, we would love to give you a sneak peek into the new BECA building. Inside our new building will be three TV studios, multiple audio facilities, a student radio station, and interconnected laboratories designed for the creation of shows on the cutting edge of media arts.
We are excited to see the new things many BECA students will create in the new building. But for now, let's celebrate what BECA students have already created.
Here are this year's beautiful BECA Awards.
Clarissa, where are the BECAs?
They were just here a minute ago. I am sure a PA is using them for a package or something.
Yeah, totally. I'm sure you're right.
Well, as they say, the show must go on. This year, BECAfest 2021 is going to look a little bit different, but we hope you stick around. We have a great show in store for you.
Yeah, it's going to be a great show. Sorry, folks. There seems to be some technical difficulties, but no worries. The show will go on.
Yeah, the show must go on. We have awards to give out.
You know what? You stay here, Clarissa. I'm gonna go get some help for the audio. But don't worry, you gave out the first award.
Oddly enough, the first category for the evening is sound for picture. These are the folks that protect us from only watching silent movies. Here are the nominees for best audio for video.
Thank you. Sound for Picture. The winner is Inside Out.
Oh my gosh. Thank you. Wait, oh wow. I just wanted to say thank you very much to all the nominees. You guys, we know how hard it is to do audio for video and all the work that we put into it. So congratulations to all of them. And thank you so much. This was one of the best teams I have worked with. So thank you to Sarah, Andrea, and Jamie. We did the best that we could. And it was just amazing memories. And these will last for a lifetime. So thank you so much.
Amidst the challenges we face this year, there is one thing that can always be enjoyed, and that's music. Music production requires intense dedication and really sets the tone for a show. But if there's anything that BECA students are great at, it's... Here are the nominees for Best Music Production.
Say goodnight to the garden. The clouds are losing their colors and turning gray. Me and my lady sitting together, watching it all, and saying goodnight to the passing day. Comes and spreads its wings with the setting sun.
For music production, the winner is Sunset, Sunrise.
Wow. thanks everyone. River Sodi, for putting on a great class over Zoom. all the great students I worked with, Alan, Kevin, Jordan, Jeff, you're here. Thanks so much.
Our next category for the evening is experimental sound. This could be a sound art composition, for example, which is a very important category that I have a lot to say about. Prompter?
Make an experimental sound. Do anything. Just make something happen.
Like, here are the nominees for Best Experimental Audio.
Jeff's losing control of himself. Why is Jeff angry?
And when it's melted, add the minced green pepper and the minced onion.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen of the radio audience. This is Sam McNamee speaking. We bring you a period of delightful entertainment sponsored by Coca-Cola. That is your drink of natural flavors.
The winner is 30s Radio.
It's truly an honor to be even nominated in any category for that matter. To be held on par with other people who enjoy this genre of audio, which is behind everything, including moving pictures, to be recognized, is truly just a labor of love. dealing with snippets and putting them together, piecing them in such a way that they have cohesiveness and they tell a story. And this story is in my heart. I come from a radio background, and so doing a project based on radio is not work. It's definite love. So I appreciate everybody in BECA, all the students, all the faculty, everybody on the panel who nominated me and voted for me. And I appreciate everybody who's watching. Thank you very much.
Thank you for that beautiful speech. Now it's time for, where are you?
Whoa, what? I'm so sorry, I didn't see you there. Maybe you can help me?
Maybe.
Well, I'm the host of BECAfest, and the show's happening right now, and everything's going wrong. There's a missing Becky, the audio's messed up, and I left my co-host at the show, and I can't find my way around
Wait. So, I'm not sure what you're talking about, but I might be able to help you with the audio problem.
Please.
Follow me.
Awesome.
Door. Building. I'm from New York. We're gonna get in here.
Okay.
Okay. There. So check this out. This is the new air booth that you're in.
Okay.
And we have a new mixer and a new automation system, and I've had a lot of numbers on it.
Okay. But
no, wait. And we also have this knob over here.
Okay, which is a knob?
Yeah.
Okay.
And you can turn it up like that anytime you want.
Okay, yeah, that's all great, but I really need help with the audio. It keeps cutting in and out.
So wait, audio is the issue?
Yeah.
Watch this.
That's it?
Sometimes, Grasshopper, the answer is in your own backyard.
Thank you.
Sure.
Dude, are you snacking during our show?
No,
Oh my god, and what the hell did you do to that box?
I found it in the new...
Look, Lupe, I'm sorry, but we really don't have time for this. We have a show to put on, and don't you think I'm hungry too? I better not hear you snacking.
Nothing in this business happens without the writers. This very show wouldn't be happening without the amazing talents of those in the writer's room. This year, many BECA students penned away amazing fiction. The nominees for Best Fiction Scripts are...
Yes, yes, I've already told you that I want you to be here by 3 p.m. Yes, yes, I know it's only 11 a.m., but you should be here in 4 hours. Don't you know how much traffic you'll get? We don't want to be late. Leave him alone. He will be on time. If you keep calling him every half an hour, what will he do? Talk to you or drive? You don't tell me to calm down. I do breathing exercises every day. I am very much calmed down. No, thank you. I can handle that myself. All right, suit yourself. What brings you here tonight? You meeting someone or something? You're all dressed up. Hey, could I get another one of these, please? And close the tab after that. Of course. Hey, I mean, I don't mean to be nosy. Hello and welcome back to What's Up Music, a show that is about all things music and only music, because we cannot get enough of music. As always, I'd like to begin with what's been up with music news over the week, and boy, do we have some hot news for you tonight. So let's get into it. But first off, ladies and gentlemen, give it up for my lovely band, The Elements.
The winner is Josh S. of the First Floor.
Thank you. I was so nervous, I switched off my camera for a second. Thank you for the recognition and opportunity, and definitely for Professor Jenin, who never gives up on her students. So that she has like really helped me to understand what script writing is. And thank you, BECA, for putting up a show in pandemic. You guys rock. Thank you.
We've all faced a year where reality is a lot stranger than fiction. And those who document so-called real life are more valuable than ever before. Here are the following nominees for Best Nonfiction Script.
If the recall efforts qualify for an election, the ballot would be broken up into two questions. The first would ask, shall Gavin Newsom be recalled from the office of governor? To which voters will answer either yes or no. The subsequent section would then follow with candidates to succeed Gavin Newsom as governor if he is recalled. This was me with the lost puppy dog, and sad most of the time. I was adorable, or so my parents told me, but really just quite naive. That was when I still believed some man was supposed to show up out of nowhere to make me feel beautiful. Why did I feel this way? Probably because I had never even been kissed. When you're the problem child, therapy starts early. I was 8 years old and a disruption in class. No parent or teacher knew what to do with me. I turned 9 and my parents took me to a therapist. I didn't know a lot about therapy, just that it was a bad thing for bad people, and I wasn't bad. When I first met Edna, I stayed silent the whole session. I didn't want therapy.
The winner is Late Bloomer, as well as Newsom Recall.
Zoe, go ahead. I welcome you to go first.
I like to thank my professor, my parents, my best friends, and the guy I kissed in Greece. So thank you.
I want to say great job to all the nominees. First and foremost, I want to thank my family who's watching from Hawaiian Gardens and Long Beach, California. Si se puede. Thank you for being so supportive my entire life. I can't imagine where I'd be without your support. I also want to thank my best friends, Mark and Cindy, my awesome boyfriend, Reese. Thank you so much for encouraging all my crazy creative reporting ideas. And last but not least, I want to give a shout out to my little baby brother, Andresito Gonzalez. Be great because you are great. We'll see you in the major leagues. Stop AAPI hate, Black Lives Matter, and free Palestine. Thank you.
Congratulations to all of our winners in the, wait, where's... Okay, what happened this time? Where did you go?
I ran, and I ran, and I ran. Excuse me. But look what's on the toilet paper.
It's a roll of toilet paper. God, Lupe, and I do not want to see what is on that toilet paper. If you had to go before the show, you should have done it beforehand. So unprofessional.
We're so close to figuring this out.
So close. We have a show to put on.
Look, you can keep the show running, but I have to figure this out. You'll be great. I promise you.
It's time to present the awards for television and video production. In a year that made Escape from Reality more valuable than ever, the following nominees for Best Video Fiction provided us with comfort, tears, and laughter. Here are the nominees.
We'll be right back. friends and birthdays. Pink is for your relationship. Light green is for physical activity. Light blue is for doctor appointments and road trips. Brown is for house tasks. Black is for to-do lists. Obstacles will come your way, but you must stick to the planner. Stick to the planner. Stick to the planner. Homework overload. Your grandfather is dying. You are entering bipolar mood swing.
Patch a few words together. And don't try to make them elaborate.
This isn't a contest, but the doorway into things and a silence in which another voice may speak.
The winner is Time Capsule by Sophia Roger.
Actually was not expecting this. Thank you so much. Just a reminder just to everyone that May is Mental Health Awareness Month, and when it comes to just taking care of yourself during quarantine, please prioritize your mental health during this, and especially within the next semester of uncertainty, online or in person, just remember to please take care of yourself. And it's an honor to win a Becky. I don't really win things, so thank you so much. I appreciate it, and congrats to the rest of the nominees. You both are incredibly talented, and yeah, thank you so much. Thank you.
Of course, tough times call for an escape, but they also call for reflection and contemplation of the world around us. Here are the nominees for Best Video Nonfiction.
You mentioned most of us have met from different cities today. As you can see, Stockton, Sacramento, Fresno, San Jose, come together as a unity, you know?
Why do you think Asians nowadays are such a big target?
To be honest with you, ever since the virus came out, you know, I don't care how many people look at it, when one of the old leaders named it as a Chinese virus and the people start calling it Kung Flu, all of a sudden just try to blame or people, you know what I'm saying? Don't try to come tackle people just because of that, just because one person say that. It's all ignorant people thinking.
Why do you think that unity across amongst all peoples is like hell important nowadays more than ever?
You know, we come here, come together.
I feel like I'm speaking for my island.
The dance because it's fun.
I've always been like intrigued with my culture, since my culture in particular is kind of dying. So I don't know too much about it. I barely know the language. So dancing was one of the, like, it's like an outlet for me emotionally, and then like I get to know a lot more about my culture.
I think for us, it's not just through politics that we try to share our story and our voice, but through dance, through our music, there's a lot comes from it. It really comes from the heart. I want the world to know our story, how we came to be as a people, how we developed as a community, even the good times and the bad times.
The full music video is now available to watch on YouTube. Moving right along, live from New York, it's Saturday Night! Saturday Night Live returned to NBC and Maya Rudolph appeared once again to play Kamala Harris. The show opened to a vice presidential debate skit, poking fun at some of the debate's most memorable moments. Gene Thompson and Jim Carrey even played that iconic fly that landed on Pence's head. Easily one of my favorite parts. I don't know about you, but I always look forward to seeing how SNL will portray the debates, and once again, they did not disappoint. Well, Love Island fans, the season 2 winners have been crowned. Justine and Caleb are the winning couple and took home the $100,000 grand prize. Recently, I spoke with season 1 contestant Katrina Demiranon about the season 2 winners and her own Love Island experience. And I want to ask you, like, how different your experience on season 1 was compared to season 2, which is now in Las Vegas.
I just feel like there's just so much more, like, drama, which makes...
The winner is... Oakland stands up against Asian hate.
So simply put, I'd like to thank my friends and my family, and I'd like to thank the folks at the Filipino channel for helping me film and come out. And this is definitely something that should be, like, the message should be spread throughout more in our media today. Thank you.
Many students use their talents this year to help a world stuck at home communicate ideas with each other. Here are the nominees for Best Video, Commercial, or PSA.
Examples of social interaction among humans dates back millions of years ago.
Our primitive ancestors would share crucial resources with each other, forging special bonds and improving rates of survival. Survival in a dangerous world may not be something to worry about much anymore, but the importance of socializing remains at the forefront of the human experience. The urge to share with others remains a major characteristic. Whether it's the everyday kind, or the special and unforgettable kind, humans have this innate ability to form unique bonds during those occurrences.
However, when 2020 came along, we found our inherently social lives upended, just like that.
This week on State of Events, we've got all the grad info you've been waiting for. In partnership with the SF State Commencement Office, I'm State of Events reporter Clarissa Gonzalez with the latest on your 2021 Graduator Breakdown. This year's commencement ceremony is set to air later this spring, May 21st, 2021. The event will be commemorating the hardworking graduating classes of fall 2020 to spring 2021 school year and will be aired via digital streaming app. To download the app, head over to your app store and search for SFSU 2021. The application includes an array of amenities, including a countdown on the front page, a Meet the Graduates tab, and a social wall. In collaborations with Hef Jones, graduation regalia is finally available on the SFSU commencement page. Place your orders by April 23rd for guaranteed delivery by May 21st. Now, regalia is not required for the virtual ceremony, so if you'd rather opt out of a cap and gown purchase, well, we've got the perfect solution for you.
Commercial or PSA? The winner is Goldilocks Gives Back by Joshua Prado.
Thank you so much for getting this award again. I'd like to once again thank my friends and my family, the folks at TFC and the folks at Goldilocks for hiring us out. It turned out the way we wanted. Thank you so much.
Sports and news broadcasting are another category of bringing people together, and the students this year applied their skills to the wide world of sports and news broadcast. Here are the nominees for Best Video, Sports, or News Package.
Under the stage red tier, the park is able to operate at 15% capacity.
It's pretty exciting. I'm really glad that they were able to get open. I'm hoping to get on some rides today.
I'm kind of a chicken, so I haven't missed the major rides, but honestly, I missed the water ride, and I missed seeing all the characters and just the whole experience.
One guest we spoke to was eager to return for a different reason.
Being a service dog handler, I think it's like, it's training opportunities, and especially I have a new puppy. We're training a lot, you know, this guy's a little rusty.
Back out here live, we are seeing guests continuing to come through the front gate. An important note, if you are planning on visiting, make sure to get a reservation on SixFlags.com. They are required to enter the park. Reporting live from Vallejo, Austin Castro, State of Events.
We're all here to stand together and unite and to stop Asian hate.
What do we do?
We need to hold everybody accountable. Everybody accountable. It's not about protecting just Asian elders. It's about protecting whoever's vulnerable. Hispanic, Black, White, it does not matter.
So after rallies in Oakland and San Francisco, we're in Central Park, San Mateo, where supporters have hosted a march and a rally against Asian racism.
Organizing the event, 13-year-old Ashton So called on the community to raise awareness of the violent acts against Asians. Joining her are local community leaders and teachers.
You know, I think that it's very important to raise awareness to this cause, and it's to tell people, you know, to put our foot down and say this isn't okay. Let's do this together, and let's stand for Asians.
How much more suffering and how much more loss of life do Asian communities have to suffer before we think this is a real issue? Name these acts for what they are. They are violence against Asians.
That's
they are
right.
Hate crimes fueled by xenophobia and racism.
That's right.
From elected leaders and to the private citizens patrolling the streets, they say they're motivated by Ashlyn's actions.
What she's doing is amazing for everyone. You know, gotta bring that energy up, like, so it's sending a message to other kids. You can really say something, your voice is gonna be heard.
These acts of physical violence today that we're witnessing across our country, across America, are a continuation of the racism that my parents faced, that your parents faced.
I've learned how important it is that when any group in our community is attacked, that we all stand up together, and that the message goes that we have a zero tolerance policy for hate in our community.
Economics and workforce development laid out all the rules, specifically the outdoor capacity for performers.
Any number of performers are permitted, provided that the performer's space allows 6 feet of distance between masked performers and 12 feet of distance between an unmasked vocalist musician and other performers.
As for large outdoor events like the city's annual music festival Outside Lands, which has been pushed back to the Halloween weekend, public officials and organizers are working together to create a reopening plan consistent with state and local safety guidelines. The full webinar is on our website, Kron4.com. Now let's take a quick look at the weather forecast for this week as I pass it off to Kron4's chief meteorologist, Nick Battle. Good morning, Nick.
Thank you, and good morning to you, Nasu. Just wanted to take a minute of your time to update you on today's storm and tomorrow's storm and the warm weekend. We are front-loading February with our best chance of rain because it's going to get quite warm and sunny as we head into the weekend. Tuesday's storm is ranked a number one on our storm impact scale with light showers. Wednesday's storm promises less wet weather, and it's not expected to hang around as long as Tuesday's. Future radar shows a few rogue showers are possible during the evening hours in Lake Mendocino and Santa Clara counties. But as we head into the overnight hours, it's going to clear out for the most part. Let me fast forward you to the weekend and show you what's coming in. We still have 50s and 60s for Friday, but Saturday we're looking in at 60s near 70 degrees. Sunday will be about the same, maybe a degree or two cooler. So definitely some outdoor weather we have here. But let's get back to Nasu.
Salesforce will begin bringing their employees back to work in their U.S. offices, starting with San Francisco's Salesforce Tower and their Palo Alto locations in May. Cronforge's Jonathan Sarabia has more insight with the story on location at Salesforce Tower. Jonathan?
Thanks, Nasu. And although Salesforce employees can voluntarily choose to return to their offices in mid-May, they must be fully vaccinated and work in cohorts of 100 people or fewer on designated floors, with safety protocols and COVID testing on site.
The winner is Six Flags Reopening by Austin Castro.
Oh my God. Okay, I've never given an acceptance speech, so let me see if I can get through this. First off, a huge thank you to the incredibly talented BECAfest team. It's been such an honor to work with you all and also, of course, hang out with fellow Beckians after over a year. And of course, meet the man, Jeff Jacoby, who I've only seen on Zoom. That I think in itself was super cool, but I gotta give a huge thank you to all of my professors in BECA as I get ready to graduate. Even though we can all agree that Zoom University can be a struggle, I think the fact that our professors really went out of our way to do what they can with the current situation was phenomenal. So I gotta give a big thank you to Rosemary Roscoe, Ashley Larson, Jeff Jacoby, Andy Pittman, Andrew Hongo, Dina Ibrahim, Elaine Young, Matias Godinez, and Yumi Wilson for preparing us for the real world. And I feel ready, more so than ever before, to take on this crazy world of broadcasting. Big shout out and thank you to my BECA partner in crime, April Scott. She puts up with me in virtually every class we have, and I think that definitely deserves an award. And of course, I gotta give a big thank you to all of my BECA friends, and of course, my super supportive family for helping me virtually in any way possible. So thank you so much. I could not be more excited to accept this award.
All of our projects require intense dedication, but none of this would be possible without the wonderful talent on screen. Here are the nominees for Best Video Talent.
I'm Austin Castro. Thanks for joining us. We begin with one of the biggest political stories of the year. After three previous attempts, a governor recall election is looking more likely than ever before.
The park wants visitors to know that face coverings are required all throughout the park, including on the ride. Bring your own to jump in. As you're about to see in a second, these rides are just as thrilling, even with all the new changes!
Contributions relating to Prop 22 now total nearly $200 million for things like these advertisements. However, of that, 90% of it has gone toward the corporate-backed yes side. From Modesto, Austin Castro, State of Events. Our first segment to get you in the Halloween mood is all about last-minute Halloween costume ideas and how after Halloween is actually the best time to buy costumes.
The president of the Engineering Student Advisory Board here at San Francisco State. John sat down with State of Events and let us know how the third largest department on campus has an immense lack of resources.
Which candidate they want to win their party's nomination. Each state holds their own primary election on a different day in the election year. For us Californians and a few other diverse states, this day is known as Super Tuesday.
Union Square is usually bustling with tourists. Today, if you can find anyone, they'll be wearing a mask.
Good afternoon, everyone. This is Madison McKay reporting for State of Events. I am currently at the corner of 19th and Holloway at the SFSU Defense Coalition protest. Protesters here are calling for the SFSU administration to stop the layoffs and use the umbrella fund.
Government officials are once again telling people who have come in contact with someone who has the coronavirus to get tested.
And I'm Madison McKay. Let's get down to our top stories of this week.
For on-air talent, the winner is Madison McKay.
I
I will make this short because I did not expect this, because Austin is the best that I know possibly and has pushed me, kept me on my toes while I've been at SF State. I cannot thank Dina Ibrahim enough for everything she's done to get me to where I am today. And Becca being a San Francisco native and my mom going to SF State and just living the journalism dream she initially wanted when she went to school, and me being able to do that now and being recognized for it means so, so much to me. I would not be here today without a lot of my BECA friends, Jessica and Katia, who I've known since freshman year, in BECA. Again, Dina and Ashley, thank you so, so much for pushing me and making me the happiest BECA winner of all right now. So thank you guys so much.
Congratulations to all of our script writing winners.
Whoa, what are you doing running through the halls like that?
Mark, I'm so happy to see you. BECAfest is happening right now, and there's something wrong with the teleprompter. Can you please help me?
The new equipment was supposed to fix that. What's wrong?
I don't know. There's just something wrong with it.
All right. Which one?
It's that one.
All right. How's that?
That's great. Thank you so much, Mark. I super appreciate it.
Good luck.
Oh, hey, look who's back.
Thanks. You won't believe.
You're right. I won't.
But I haven't even told you.
I think it might be for the best.
Cool. I'll be right back.
Radio is one of the oldest forms of mass media, and the incredible popularity of podcasting is bringing it back. Here are the nominees for Best Radio Show or Podcast.
Although we're alone in the 2001 Toyota Camry that would one day become my first car, today I'm buckled in place behind the empty passenger seat. Likely a habit left over from growing up the younger of two children. I knew my place. On the way home from an unextraordinary day of 8th grade, she's driving us to the local grocery store to pick up some ingredients for tonight's dinner.
Sure.
Without removing her eyes from the road in front of her, she blindly passes the auxiliary cable backwards to me. Despite this drive taking no more than 5 minutes going the long way, my 12-year-old attention span demands to fill each moment with stimulation. Besides, there's this song I haven't been able to get out of my head. I lean forward across the center console to plug in my purple iPod Shuffle. Its 16 gigabytes of memory are strained by a massive and meticulously organized iTunes library. Scrolling past the likes of MGMT, Vampire Weekend, and other early 2010 indie rockers, I land upon my latest obsession.
Battle of the Bulge. Nazi soldiers would be taught to speak perfect English and dress as Allied soldiers. These soldiers would spread disinformation, spy, and sow discord among the Allied troops. My grandfather was accused of being one of these Nazi provocateurs. An American soldier pointed his rifle at Paul's head and asked him a few questions.
Who won the World Series? What is Babe Ruth's number?
The Tigers, number 3.
Where are you from?
Chicago, the Northwest Side.
Oh yeah? What's your address?
2100 Springfield, near Pulaski and Irving.
I live across the alley.
Underground and exploitative were often shown at or after midnight due to the fact that mainstream film audiences understandably might not care for the content being shown. As such, they've been referred to as midnight movies. Now that that's out of the way, we can get to the main content of the episode, which, as I stated before, will be the films of John Waters and the Kucher Brothers.
Well, I just use common sense. I mean, if they're smart, they're queer. And if they're stupid, they're straight.
Waters was born in 1946 to upper-class parents in Baltimore, that is, the capital of Maryland, for those not so geographically inclined. He had a pretty normal suburban upbringing, but realized his sexuality from a pretty early age, being quoted as saying, "I knew I was gay when I looked at Elvis for the first time." Surprisingly, his mid-century Roman Catholic parents were quite supportive of his lifestyle, and As his career blossomed into the 70s and his films became larger in scale, it was his parents who did the majority of the funding.
Show or podcast, the winner is The Edge of Captivity by Kevin Pennick.
I was not expecting that. I just want to say thanks to my instructor, Rajiv Naidu. He helped me make this project listenable. And thanks to my dad, who told me the story. Hey, everyone. And also, thanks to my grandfather for fighting fascists. And I want to say congrats to everyone who got through the last couple of semesters as well. So it was pretty tough. So yeah, right on.
In a year where access to live sports was extremely limited and the news was often too disheartening to hear, the following nominees kept us in touch with some of our greatest traditions. Here are the nominees for Best Radio or Podcast, News or Sports Package.
Andy Reid has landed on his feet. I'm so happy for him as for what he did for my Eagles and making them relevant. I'm a Patrick Mahomes fan. I love everything Andy's doing with those guys over there. I'm good. The Chiefs are right where they should be. 2-0, and they'll continue to be. They'll continue. They'll win 14 games and they'll go right back to the Super Bowl and win it again. Back to back champs.
The two LA teams, Chargers and the Rams.
All right. So first, let's do the Chargers. I got a question for you. You tell me. Somebody tries to puncture your lung. Do you go back into that doctor's office?
No.
Somebody accidentally punctures your lung. Do you go back to that doctor's office?
No.
So I'm an offensive lineman. I need a flu shot. I ain't going to see that trainer. I'm a wide receiver. I need a cortisone shot. You ain't sticking me with any. This could possibly derail the Chargers.
For news or sports program, the winner is football segment.
I appreciate that. First, let me congratulate everybody that was nominated in every category. Great job not using the pandemic as the reason to excuse a failure or shortcomings. You know, this has been a tough year. We spent a lot of this time celebrating people who are no longer with us. We're celebrating bad circumstances, so it's great to, at my time at San Francisco State, getting some love. And congratulations to everybody. Congratulations to me. Thank you again. I appreciate it.
Creating an important message in such a short period of time is a true art form. Here are the nominees for Best Radio, Commercial, or PSA.
Jill is among the 65% of American kids unable to read at grade level by the time they're in fourth grade. These kids face a troubling future, with the majority dropping out of school and struggling to earn a living. But then Jill met a Reading Partners volunteer. For more than 20 years, the Bay Area nonprofit has been pairing volunteers with kids to provide extra help with reading and comprehension.
When I started being second graders and coming to Reading Partners, it helps you learn.
Just 1 hour per week makes all the difference. On average, Reading Partners students more than double their rate of learning while in the program. Now Jill can look forward to becoming a confident reader with a passion for learning and a much brighter future.
A very bad snowstorm, it's called a blizzard. Snow can fall for a long time.
You know, when Mama cooked, nobody could beat the fresh aroma that came from her kitchen. Somehow, the sauce was always just right. The pasta so fresh. The taste so delicious. Now, there's only one name to think of for food like Mama's. Celentano's Italian frozen entrees, with the freshness of a home-cooked meal. Lasagna, ravioli, manicotti, stuffed shells. Just like Mama used to make, only with fewer calories. Celentano, Do it for yourself. Do it for Mama.
There is a dimension of music that is alternative to the mainstream. Dane and Ernest take you on the experience of a sonic alternative. It is the leading podcast for indie rock and alternative music from the underground. Each week, your hosts will share a playlist of obscure music.
Visit us on anchor.fm/sonicalternative. For more indie and alternative content, follow us on Instagram at sonicalternative and on Twitter at sonalternative.
For commercial or PSA, the winner is Reading Partners.
Thank you so much. I didn't hear my name at first there, so I wasn't surprised to hear it. Thank you so much for that recognition. It's really a boost of confidence in somebody who's starting a new career in sort of a later time in my life. So really, I really appreciate it. I made this a little bit before the pandemic, so thankfully I was able to work directly with some of our instructors. So Rajiv Naidu was instrumental in just kind of opening my mind to the creative possibilities of audio. And Len Hayes as well was really good for me at teaching me the technical aspects and again, what we could do with audio. And also Jeff Jacoby was persistent is the word for trying to get us to get our work in to the BECAfest. So thank you. It only took about 5 minutes for me to think about actually submitting this. So now I've got a Becky and I couldn't be happier. I'm so thrilled. Really, it means a lot to me. I hadn't gotten awards for things, so I really appreciate it. And that's it. Thank you so much. Everybody's work was really, really, really impressive and I'm super inspired. So thank you so much for including me in this.
I'm so close, I can feel it.
You know, how do I say this, Lupe? You don't really have to keep coming back. You know, I think I got this.
Huh.
Yeah, you know, it's just something I've been thinking about for a long time, and I just don't feel like we're on the same page, you know? I and it's not you, it's me.
Of course!
Excuse me?
How did we not see this before?
See what?
Look, I figured it out. I don't have time to explain, but we have to go.
Go where? We have the last award to give out.
We have to go. Come on, let's go. Let's go.
Oh my God.
Where do you think you're going? The show must go on.
Wait, when did you change?
We got you now, Allie. Huh? You can't hide from us anymore. Jeff Rosenstock? Ah, Jeff Rosenstock. What's with the alligator suit?
Well, I was just bringing it over to the new building.
And the audio?
My dog Ruby chewed on the cord. I was just getting you a new one.
What about the teleprompter?
Oh, yeah, I tripped over the cord and broke the teleprompter.
Okay, but what about the animal crackers?
Oh, I just like animal crackers.
And the Becky?
I just really wanted a Becky.
Yeah, about that. We need it for the show right now, so I'm gonna have to take that back.
All right, Lupe, let's go. Thanks.
Hello, folks. I hope you're enjoying BECAfest 2021. This is the moment in the show where, as a faculty member in the BECA department, I have the privilege of announcing the Faculty Choice Award. The Faculty Choice Award is given to a show that was nominated in its category, but did not win the Becky. Yet the faculty feels that this show deserves a Becky anyway. So for BECAfest 2021, the Faculty Choice Award goes to... wait a second. I have it here somewhere. Yeah, I know it's here. Hang on. Got it. Faculty Choice Award goes to Pay Attention by Kayla Bowler, Gabrielle Petty, Kayla Nason, and LaRon Richardson. Congratulations.
You have seen the best of BECA 2021, but really, none of us could do it alone. We still have one last set of awards to present.
They are the backbone of the BECA department.
The unsung heroes that we rely on year after year.
We present these awards to Jeff Rosenstock on behalf of the BECA Technical Department. Thank you for everything that you do.
And thank you so much for joining us for BECAfest 2021. We hope you had a great night, and we'll see you later, Gators.